primo com'è?
È bellissimo, eh? È una gioia grandissima. Sono...
riesci a godertelo, sì?
Sì, come no, come no, è bellissimo, una gioia indescrivibile.
Sometimes a story needs to begin at the end, because on the 21st of May 1995, we didn't merely say farewell to a player who for 5 years had been so important to Juve and their fans.
Ti viene da pensare? La prima cosa al fischio dell'arbitro, che hai pensato?
Ma sono tante le cose, ovviamente. Sono felice per questa squadra, dei miei compagni, per chi ha lottato un anno per arrivare fino a qua.
That day was also significant for another reason, because it was our first Scudetto for 9 years, almost a decade in which we had ceded the spotlight to other clubs. There was a feeling that we were beginning a new cycle and that this title wasn't a one-off.
Lo sai che siamo in diretta?
Ah no, lo sapevo. Vabbè, comunque siamo felicissimi.
Il contratto.
La dedica, tutti bravi? Sì, sì. Galeazzi grida il contratto, ma io non
contratto,
sento.
Contratto, contratto.
There was also a nagging suspicion that Roberto Baggio was no longer going to be our number 10. Among the songs and banners dedicated to him, he was saying goodbye. Baggio's next destination was unknown, but it was clear he was leaving Turin. And this was his lap of honour. As you would expect, he left us with another masterstroke, his umpteenth work of art. That backheel was a response to some of his critics. Some said that Baggio wasn't a winner and was too much of a loner for the Bianconeri, not a team player. Was that backheel enough to disprove these theories and suggest the number 10 still had plenty to offer?
Oggi è uno di quei giorni in cui non si pensa a domani.
No, oggi facciamo durare più a lungo possibile.
Few people captured the essence of the divine ponytail better than writer Eduardo Galeano, who said, "No one has given the Italians so much wonderful football or reasons to argue than Baggio in recent years." Between the mid-1980s and start of this millennium, no one created debate and emotion like the extraordinary number 10, who is beyond any doubt unique. He played in an era when number 10s in Italy began to experience tactical constraints and powerful muscular football took control. Baggio gave everything to build his reputation and play the football he wanted, with freedom and creativity. He put himself in this position as someone who was given allowances because of his unusual career path. We witnessed Roberto close up for several years, and the question is, as is often the case with all Bianconeri legends, how important was he to our success? The subject first came up in the summer of 1990, when the former Fiorentina idol came up north to Turin with expectation that would crush any normal person. A lot was expected. Baggio cost the king's ransom, and new manager Gigi Maifredi viewed the player as the perfect man to help him deliver his ultra-attacking, exciting new style. We had already been first-hand witnesses to Baggio's outrageous ability when he played against us. And if that weren't enough to convince people, the 23-year-old had just been Italy's most eye-catching player, along with Schillaci, at the World Cup. But now they were expected to transfer their gifts to the black and white shirt. Could Roberto handle the immense pressure? Judging by his start, he was ready. He scored in his first Juve match in every competition. And the goals flowed, 17 in the first 18 matches. We hadn't had such a prolific number 10 since Michel Platini. Comparisons with Louis were unavoidable. If results had been going our way, the various theories and appraisals of the new man would have been a pleasing distraction among press and fans. However, things didn't go well, and Juve finished the season in seventh place. Baggio's role in this failure, and if he was tactically damaging the team, was the main talking point. On the plus side, he scored 27 goals. His free kicks were Zico-esque, and Platini labelled him similar to Maradona. But Michel added, "Baggio is a second striker who scores a lot, but I don't know if he is mentally ready to carry the entire team." The Frenchman defined Roberto a 9.5. It was fitting, because it was a shirt number which didn't exist in football, and hit a note, as the modern game relegated the importance and reliance upon players like Baggio. They were no longer considered vital to the function of the team.
Concede il calcio di punizione alla formazione bianconera. Ecco, avevi proprio, Roberto, visto giusto quando avevi espressamente richiesto una gara ai calci di punizione. Platini ha sbagliato di poco, con una conclusione che non è tipicamente delle sue. Vediamo se Baggio invece si proporrà con una punizione alla Baggio. Attenzione a Baggio, tutto è pronto, parte Baggio. Ai ai ai, è gol, è gol.
Senti Michel, c'è un numero 10 nuovo nella Juventus, questa Juventus del 90. Che cosa manca a Baggio per diventare grande come Michel?
Ma lasciamolo fare la sua strada e dopo giudicherete fra 5 o 6 anni.
Things moved rapidly and Giovanni Trapattoni replaced Gigi Maifredi. The results improved, but the team was still far from winning the Scudetto. Baggio continued scoring goals in quantity and of quality, but little changed. However, the man himself developed. Roberto was more of a leader and a battler, demonstrating willpower and the attitude to go with the captain's armband, which he now wore. And that's how Roberto finally got his hands on silverware in his third season. The Vecchia Signora couldn't get near Fabio Capello's mighty Milan, but Baggio had glorious moments in the league.
Centro di Torricelli, numero 10 bianconero, apre la sua domenica speciale.
He scored 4 against Udinese, and it should have been 5, but for a minor deflection.
Mai aveva segnato in una sola gara 4 reti. Gli riesce al 41esimo su cross di Galia.
Adesso, perché è andata bene una partita, non è che dobbiamo così considerare questo ruolo per sempre. Io credo che se la squadra gioca in questa maniera posso giocare anche davanti, però è chiaro che dipende tutto da tutti, ecco, da tutti insieme.
Sei andato alla fine vicino alla curva dei tifosi?
Sì, sono andato così a ringraziarli perché mi avevano così acclamato per tutta la partita. Avevo promesso ai ragazzi di fare una buona gara e ci sono riuscito.
Robby saved his best for Europe. In the UEFA Cup semi-final first leg against PSG, Juve went a goal down at the Dele Alpi. Baggio resolved the situation, and his celebration embodied the relief and ecstasy of everyone connected with the Bianconeri, who was influential in the second leg in France, and once more in the final against Borussia Dortmund.
Palla sorpresa per Platt, che mette in mezzo, Artiglia, Vialli, si gira e c'è il gol della Juventus! E c'è il gol della Juventus con Roberto Baggio! La Juve alla prima occasione è stata abilissima a sfruttarla, Roberto Baggio ha messo dentro!
Ci riesce comunque a crossare, Baggio davanti al portiere, gol! 2-2-2 per la Juventus. Palla buona, vediamo Baggio che incrocia il tiro e la palla che colpisce il palo finisce in gol! 3-1, grandissima giocata di Roberto Baggio.
Diceva Roberto Baggio gioca bene, fa gli assist, fa i gol, ma non ha mai vinto niente nella sua carriera. Questo fino alle ore 20:30 di oggi. Adesso?
Adesso non lo dico più.
The Divine Ponytail scored 30 times in 1992-93, his most in a season. Baggio was much more than the captain of a cup-winning Juve. The way he played was reminiscent of childhood football. The way he picked the ball up and dribbled around opponents. Back to Galeano, who said, Roberto Baggio's style is a mystery. The legs have minds of their own. His foot shoots on its own. His eyes visualize the goal before everything combines. It was a one-man campaign to bring the elegance and pleasure back to football. France Football declared Baggio winner of the 1993 Ballon d'Or, ahead of Dennis Bergkamp.
Sono molto felice questo. I'm about to go off like a weapon. Fuel to the top, got a filled up engine. In my thoughts, obsession, I will not stop, no, I'm never second guessing. I got a God complex, haters love to hate, but I never feel pressed. Got a lot on my plate, but I never get stressed. I'll take all the pressure like I'm acing this test. Oh, tear it up like I'm Jason.
To be one of the most complicated spells of his career. Juve weren't winning a lot, and the World Cup was an agonizing mixture of emotions. He single-handedly dragged Italy to the final with moments of sheer brilliance, but missed his penalty in the shootout in the final against Brazil.
Quando ritroverai Baggio, che cosa dirai? La prima cosa che gli dirai?
Ho fatto buone vacanze. Credo sia indispensabile per lui ricaricarsi dopo una stagione che si è conclusa con un mondiale che credo che l'avrà sicuramente stressato molto e anche stancato molto. Noi adesso stiamo cercando di costruire una squadra solida in cui lui si possa inserire e magari dare un tocco di qualità in più.
Marcello Lippi was the new boss in Turin, and yet another phase beckoned for the Divine Ponytail. There was a shift in focus and it became clear that if Juve wanted to be league champions again, they couldn't rely on one player, even if he was Roberto Baggio. Baggio started the season with several post-World Cup injuries. Juve demonstrated the mental strength to power through in his absence.
Domenica sera contro l'Inter rientrerà Roberto Baggio? L'annuncio di Lippi.
Sta bene, ha voglia di giocare ed è uno di quei giocatori che quando stanno bene fisicamente debbono giocare.
Sono contento. Normale, no?
Hai detto che speri di non indebolire la squadra.
Sì, è una battuta. Visto che la squadra va benissimo, spero che con il mio rientro continui su questa strada.
As soon as he returned, Baggio was back to himself. In Cremona, he replicated his goal against Spain in the USA. He struck in the big match against Milan, when we realized that Juve was serious about ripping the Scudetto patch from the Rossoneri shirts and stitching it onto the black and white kit.
Beh, era importantissimo riuscire a fare bene, perché soprattutto per noi stessi. È chiaro, abbiamo vinto contro il Milan, adesso abbiamo regalato una grande gioia ai nostri tifosi.
But the up and down nature of the season was evident at Padova. Robbie scored a trademark free kick before injury forced him to sit out for a while. It was a stop-start campaign.
Ecco, comunque sei sorridente, il ginocchio va bene.
Aggiornato.
Il ginocchio va bene.
Sì, bene, grazie.
Tu non volevi uscire quando ti ho chiamato lì, però voglio continuare, vero?
Sì, volevo giocare ancora, però ha fatto bene, perché fra due giorni abbiamo una partita importantissima.
Intanto la palla è sistemata in una posizione dalla quale Roberto Baggio può provare il suo destro. Tiro e il gol! Grandissimo gol di Roberto Baggio, e la Juve di nuovo in vantaggio.
Baggio still came up with pearls in Italy and the UEFA Cup. His influence in the league grew towards the end of the season, particularly in the match in Reggio Emilia. And even though he left everyone open-mouthed on the pitch, the talk was more about whether he would be offered or sign a new contract. Juve already had his heir, Alessandro Del Piero. After 200 matches and 115 goals in 5 seasons, Baggio left the number 10 shirt to the youngster. Alex went on to achieve even more, from on-pitch stats to trophies won, and a special role in the fans' hearts. There was still lots for Baggio to give football after Juve, although he never touched the heights of previously. He returned to Turin and scored in the Bologna and Brescia shirts, helped by another old Bianconero in the form of Giancarlo Marocchi, and a future black and white icon, Andrea Pirlo. Those classic Robbie goals brought a hint of regret and nostalgia, as often occurs in love stories which never develop as fully as hoped.